Hi, this is Amish Agarwal. I'm an advocate practicing in Delhi, and I wanted to make a quick video about what you have to do as the first and foremost step if you are arrested by the Narcotics Control Bureau, or for that matter, a couple of other organizations which I'll be talking about a little later in this video. Now, you see, the legislature, the parliament, or the British Crown before the independence always understood that when you give wide powers of investigation to the police and they are given unfettered powers to do as they please during the investigation to ensure a fair trial and justice at the end of the day, sometimes they can get carried away. Sometimes they might want to record confessions, admissions, and not really bother with actual investigative work. And that is why the Evidence Act, which was passed hundreds of years ago, also said that no confession given to the police or in police custody will be admissible as evidence during the trial. However, the Indian Parliament, after independence, of course, has made certain departures from that rule of evidence, rule of criminal jurisprudence, and has held that certain confessions, even when made in custody, are admissible as evidence. And the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act is one of those acts. So what happens is that Section 67 of the NDPS Act says that officers which are authorized under the Act are having the powers to summon and to record the statement of any person, including accused persons. And therefore, under Section 67, confessions can also be recorded by officers of departments such as the Narcotic Control Bureau, as well as the DRI, which is the Directorate of Revenue Intelligence, I believe, also under the also by the Enforcement Directorate, also by officers of the Central Excise Departments when it existed, by officers of the GST Department. So these are all confessional statements, and I've in the past made a video about how if the police make you sign a document or a confession, there's no problem because it's not admissible as evidence. This is a departure from that rule of criminal jurisprudence. And if you are, say, arrested by the NCB involving a drugs matter, and the first thing that you need to do is to remember is that you must file a retraction application before the magistrate the moment you are produced before that magistrate. Because the Supreme Court has, I don't remember the name of the judgment, but the Supreme Court has in that judgment said that if a retraction is not filed at the earliest possible opportunity before the magistrate, then that confession will be deemed to be accurate, will be deemed to be admissible, and can be used against the accused person to secure a conviction. And therefore, if you are arrested, in all likelihood, your statement will be recorded. We don't know whether it will be, whether it will be voluntary or involuntary. At the trial, the prosecution will try to establish that it was indeed voluntary. The accused person will try to establish that it was involuntary, and to lend more credibility to the fact that you knew that it was involuntary, you must move a retraction application either yourself or through your lawyer or through a well-wisher also called a perocar. And you need to do that at the earliest possible opportunity. Otherwise, the Supreme Court jurisprudence says that this evidence will be held against you, and just this confessional statement can be used to secure a conviction against you by the NCB under the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act. There are several other aspects to criminal trials, especially involving narcotic drugs, and maybe I'll talk about them in future videos, but that's it for now.